Leia here from leiaforsci.com, and in this MCAT video, we're going to look at oxidation and reduction reactions. What are oxidation and reduction reactions, or rather, what sets them apart from the other reactions that you see? And the answer is simple. The molecules that react are going to have a change in oxidation number. When something gets oxidized or reduced, its oxidation number will go up or down. In the last video, we looked at how to find the oxidation number, as well as how to recognize common oxidizing and reducing reagents. So let's take it a step further and see how this works with redox reactions. First, a quick review of my favorite mnemonic. Leo the lion says, "Grr!" And this tells us a loss of electrons is oxidation, a gain of electrons is reduction, where loss of electron can also mean loss of hydrogen or gain of oxygen atom. And gain of electron can also be gain of hydrogen or loss of oxygen atom. For more details on this, see the oxidation number video linked below or visit my website leiaforsci.com/reactions. Take a look at this partial reaction where SN2+ goes to SN4+. This is an incomplete reaction because we know that charge cannot be created or destroyed, only transferred. And if we add up the charges on both sides, SN2+ gives us +2, SN4+ gives us +4, and this doesn't match up. What we're missing here are negative electrons. The one that's higher will be brought down by adding negative, by adding electrons. What's the difference between 4 and 2? 2 electrons. Positive 4 is greater than positive 2 by 2. That means we have to add +2 electrons to the product side so that we now have a net charge on the right of +4 - 2 = +2, +2 = +2, so we know we have the correct number of electrons. Is this an oxidation or reduction reaction? Well, let's see. What happens to tin +2? When tin loses 2 negatives, it gets more positive by 2, which is why the charge goes up by 2. And we have 2 electrons that are now lost floating away into solution to be picked up by something else. Because tin lost electrons, this is an oxidation reaction. Now take a look at this reaction. If 2 Fe3+ reacts to give me 2 Fe2+, what happened? Iron started with a positive 3 and went down to positive 2. How do we figure out if it's oxidation or reduction? Let's see what happened to the electrons. The net charge in the reactant side is 2 times positive 3, which is +6. The net charge on the products is 2 times positive 2, which is +4. The side with a higher charge has to be brought down with electrons, and in this case, it has to be brought down with 2 electrons. That means in this reaction, 2 electrons react with 2 iron 3+ to give us 2 iron 2+. Because the iron 3+ is gaining electrons, the iron is getting reduced. That means this is a reduction reaction. One way you can recognize this is electrons on the product side as oxidation, electrons in the reactant side as reduction. But what if you don't see it this way? These are both half reactions, meaning we have the oxidation half, the reduction half, but in reality they happen together because redox reactions happen in pairs. The balanced redox reaction is SN2+ aqueous reacts with 2 Fe3+ aqueous to give us SN4+ aqueous plus 2 Fe2+ aqueous. We know that electrons are transferred, but without seeing this, how do you know which side gained and lost electrons? The proper way to do this is to separate it into the half reactions, to write out the equation for SN2+ to 4+, write out the equation for Fe3+ to 2+, and figure it out as we did before. But guess what? You don't have this kind of time on the MCAT, so if you understand what's going on, here's how I like to do it instead. When tin got oxidized, it went up in charge. The charge went from +2 up to +4. What if we spell up with an O? Up in charge for oxidation. When iron got reduced, it went from +3 down to +2. Or we can say that +3 was reduced to +2. Iron 3 is reduced to iron 2. And if you can recognize this, you don't have to write it all out. All you do is compare. Which charge is higher or lower? +2 goes up to +4, oxidation. Iron +3 is reduced to iron +2. That's the reduced or reduction. What if it's not obvious? What if you were given the reaction of H2 gas reacting with O2 gas to give you water? This is a redox reaction, but what is getting oxidized and what is getting reduced? In order to figure this out, you have to assign the oxidation number to the individual atoms and then figure out which one went up and which one was reduced in charge. Remember from the last video that a standard state element, or a neutral molecule made up of one type of atom, is going to have an oxidation number of 0. That means each hydrogen has an oxidation number of 0, and each oxygen also 0. When looking at water, we have to break it apart, and we can remember that oxygen typically has an oxidation number of -2, or that when hydrogen is bound to a nonmetal, it has an oxidation number of +1, and two hydrogens at +1 balances out a -2. Now we can compare the atoms directly. Hydrogen's oxidation number went from 0 to +1. It went up from 0 to +1. Up equals oxidation. Oxygen's oxidation number was reduced from 0 down to -2. It was reduced, telling us that oxygen underwent reduction. And as we discussed in the last video, if hydrogen is getting oxidized, it is also the reducing agent. If oxygen is getting reduced, it is also the oxidizing agent. Redox will come up in a lot of the common types of reactions, so let's look at them one at a time. I like to think of disproportionation reactions as being disproportionate or uneven, because one atom can be oxidized and another of the same atom can be reduced. For example, why does a peroxide solution typically come in a dark bottle? So that it's not exposed to light, and so that it doesn't decompose by this reaction. H2O2 liquid will break down to give us H2O liquid plus O2 gas. What in this reaction underwent oxidation and reduction? We know that the peroxy anion has an oxidation number of -1 per oxygen. This is the O2 -2 exception. But the remaining oxygens, if in a molecule, will have -2. If in a standard state element, we'll have an oxidation number of 0. Hydrogen bound to a nonmetal is +1. Hydrogen bound to a nonmetal is +1. Hydrogen did not undergo redox. Oxygen did. And specifically, oxygen underwent oxidation and reduction. The oxygen that winds up in water went down or was reduced from -1 to -2. That's the reduction reaction. The oxygen that became O2 gas went up in charge from -1 to 0, giving us up for oxidation. Take a look at this reaction. We know it's a single replacement because on one side we have chlorine with nothing, on the other side it's attached to something. Same thing with bromine. Bromine with nothing, bromine with something. How is this a redox reaction? Notice that we have ionic compounds in the reactants and products where potassium is simply a spectator on both sides. What's actually reacting is chlorine and bromine. Chlorine in its standard state is 0. Bromine in its standard state is 0. If bromine is balanced by a positive spectator, it's got a charge of -1, or simply recognize halogens as -1. Same with the chlorine on the product side. So how is this a redox reaction? Chlorine went from 0 down or reduced to -1, making it the reduction half reaction, and bromine went up or up from -1 to 0, making it the oxidation half reaction. A combination or synthesis reaction is when we bring two things together. Haven't we already seen that in the formation of water from its standard state elements? In this case, hydrogen and oxygen combine to give us water, and we've seen that hydrogen gets oxidized while oxygen gets reduced. A decomposition reaction is a reaction where something breaks apart. What if we reverse this synthesis reaction, showing that two water molecules can break apart to give me H2 gas and O2 gas. Since this is the reverse of synthesis, we would expect that hydrogen getting oxidized in the forward reaction would get reduced in the reverse, and that oxygen getting reduced in the forward should get oxidized in the reverse. Let's prove it. Let's first assign oxidation states, hydrogen plus 1, oxygen minus 2. Hydrogen and oxygen are 0 in their elemental states. So what do we have? Hydrogen goes down or gets reduced from plus 1 to 0. Oxygen goes up, increasing from negative 2 to 0, which proves that in the reverse reaction, hydrogen gets reduced and oxygen gets oxidized. Last but not least, we have combustion, which is a burning reaction. So let's look at the simple combustion of reacting methane with 2 oxygen gas to give us carbon dioxide and 2 water. What is getting oxidized and what is getting reduced? Let's start with oxidation numbers. Remember that hydrogen bound to a metal is negative, but non-metal is positive. This gives me plus 1 times 4 for the hydrogen, and therefore minus 4 for the carbon. Oxygen in its standard state is 0, but in the products, oxygen in a compound is minus 2, and since we have 2 of them, 2 times negative 2 is negative 4, carbon has to be positive 4. In water, we have hydrogen plus 1, oxygen minus 2. Notice that hydrogen hasn't changed. It started and ended as plus 1, but carbon and oxygen have different oxidation numbers. Carbon started off as negative 4 and went up by 8 so that its final oxidation number is positive 4. Carbon went up, giving us the oxidation reaction. Oxygen started with 0, but went down or was reduced to minus 2, giving us the reduction half of the reaction. For even more on reactions, be sure to join me in the next video where we look at chemical reactions in much more detail. First, give this video a thumbs up. Make sure to subscribe to my channel so that you don't miss out on any new MCAT videos. Then visit my website, leahfrisai.com/reactions, for the MCAT stoichiometry and reactions practice quiz and cheat sheet. The link again, leahfrisai.com/reactions.